Tony came to Australia with wife Roz and their three children in 1978 and joined B'nai B'rith in March 1979.
I first met Tony 30 years ago, in fact more than 30 years ago, when I was a student activist with Orgis.
Tony is a longest serving staff member at Jewish Care and an exemplar of our values of kindness, charity, family and respect.
He really is a mensch and he is so able to talk to people across the community about community, about the importance of Jewish values, about why he values what he does. And that really is what Tony is all about.
I used to think that I could not go on.
Tony, as a stalwart of the organisation, has always been committed to the values and principles of B'nai B'rith.
As a staff member at Jewish Care, it really makes us very, very proud of Tony.
It's really about his unflappable nature and his calmness and his sense of ease in his job.
In the 10 years or so that I've known Tony, he has been inclusive, fair in his decision making, and a perfect mentor.
And I can do it if I just believe it. There's nothing to
Tony's skills and his ability to teach us and impart his knowledge of how to speak in public have stayed with me and I know with many of my colleagues for many years.
He sets an exceptional standard at Jewish Care and he's an outstanding citizen of the Melbourne Jewish community.
Tony has been president of B'nai B'rith Victoria on two separate occasions. The first time goes back to 1993 to 1997, and then in more recent times, 2011 to 2013. Tony has also been chair of the B'nai B'rith Anti-Defamation Commission for two terms, and he continues to sit on the board of the ADC.
I was on the verge of breaking down sometimes.
I have also been told of the years that Tony was involved with the JCCV, where he was on their executive for 10 years, and also chairman of the Social Justice Committee. And it was during this time he brought to the attention of the community the issue of poverty.
He is so interested in everyone. He sets a level for exceptional customer service at Jewish Care each and every day.
It's a very sensitive area, the area of requests and planned giving, and the reason I think that Tony has been so successful at doing that is that he engenders a sense of trust and respect and loyalty in the people that he visits and attends to, and I think that really sets him apart.
I think about it every night and day, spread my wings and fly away.
When Tony was chairman of B'nai B'rith Victoria in the 90s, he didn't have a mobile phone. At the time, he was employed by a company in the city, but wouldn't make private calls. So, in his lunchtime, he would hurry to the public phone to call B'nai B'rith office to ensure that the organisation was still running.
He's so debonair. He's almost like a James Bond type character with his beautiful white, silvery hair, the way he strolls through a corridor, the way he commands attention. He really could have been a James Bond character, couldn't he?
Of course, one cannot leave Roz out of all of this, and although a B'nai B'rith stalwart in her own right, she has always been there by Tony's side.
I really congratulate him for his care, his commitment, his contribution that he's made to the Jewish community over these many, many years.
Roz was telling me that earlier this year, on the day Tony received the letter from Canberra that he was to be a recipient of an OAM, he could not understand why. We, B'nai B'rith Victoria, are very proud and congratulate you, Tony, on receiving the General Sir John Monash Award. Mazel tov.
Tony, on behalf of your team at Jewish Care, and in fact everybody at Jewish Care, I want to wish you and Roz and the whole family mazel tov on this fantastic award. It really is well deserved.
Tony, on behalf of the Jewish Care Board and the leadership team, We congratulate you on this outstanding award tonight. We hope you and your family and your friends are enjoying this wonderful accolade. Thank you so much for the many, many years of care, commitment and contribution to the Melbourne Jewish community. Come.